I would like to start my presentation with a quote from Dr. Paul Farmer. He said, "I can't show you how exactly healthcare is a basic human right, but what I can argue is that no one should have to die of a disease that is treatable." This quote really resonates with me and my research project overall. I have grown up in Rwanda, a low-income country. I have experienced firsthand people dying from diseases that are treatable, but not because of other reasons, but because of high cost of drugs or low access to healthcare services. Many of my friends lost their parents when they were still young. They were forced to be parents to their younger siblings because of high drug costs or because of diseases that should have been treated or prevented. This is still happening in many low-income countries. Many people are dying because they can't access care or they don't have means to buy medicines. From this experience, I learned to use my knowledge and help people who are in need, help people who do not have access to care, and help people like my parents' friend to have access to treatment through research. After graduating from college, I joined a non-government organization that was working in close collaboration with the Rwanda Ministry of Health to help vulnerable people have access to modern treatment and those who were in need, especially HIV patients. At that time, we worked with rural areas, and one of the projects that I worked on was on hepatitis C. Hepatitis C is an infectious disease, and it attacks primarily the liver, and it can lead to comorbidities if not treated at early stage or death. But it's cured if treated at early stage. But many people still do not have access to hepatitis drug because of high cost or because of low access to treatment. This is what has been happening in Rwanda. Many people have been diagnosed and did not have access to therapy. The project that I worked on was to develop a database that registered patients in Rwanda and help see how many patients had hepatitis C or how many were accessing treatment. Surprisingly, this is what we found. Of 55,000 patients who had hepatitis C, only 223 at that time in 2015 had access to treatment. To tackle this issue, the government of Rwanda negotiated price reduction, and the full cost of treatment reduced per person from $96,000 to $780. It's a high price for income country settings. To maximize the benefit of this reduction, the Ministry of Health launched a mass screening across the country, and patients who were screened and confirmed positive, they were initiated for treatment free of charge. Those patients who also did not know their hepatitis C status, it was a chance for them to know their status. It's great news, right? Now people who have been waiting for treatment for so many years, they had access to care and they had hope to be treated again. However, there are still some questions that are not answered. Even if we have this program, but we have to learn whether the program reached everyone who was in need. And this is what I will be doing in partnership with Rwanda Ministry of Health as my research project. We have to ask whether people who initiated treatment were cured. What is the burden of hepatitis C? Did patients complete treatment? Did everyone who started treatment completed it or not? And why did not some patient complete treatment? Those are the questions that I will respond to quantitatively, but I recognize the importance of giving patient a voice as well. That's why my study will also include qualitative part, where we'll interview patients and ask them the challenges through care. I want to ask them, now that the treatment is free, why patients maybe are not completing treatment? Why now patients are dropping out before they are cured? I also want to learn from those who were cured, the success stories. What are the facilitators? What the factors influenced them to remain in care? so that their success stories can be shared with other countries in low-income countries. This is my research project overall, and I hope that it will inform the government of Rwanda, because recently the Minister of Health launched an elimination plan. We have a goal of eliminating hepatitis C by 2023, and my research project is the first step towards this ambitious goal. I want to inform Minister of Health on priority areas or the level of care for hepatitis C that need more interventions. I will also conduct cost-effectiveness analysis to inform Minister of Health in terms of resource allocation. I would like to thank PSI for the support, because without your support, I couldn't do my study. I would like also to thank Rwanda Minister of Health to give me the opportunity to work on this interesting project, and my supervisor for his guidance and support as well. I hope that my research project will help and contribute to a better Rwandan community where people do not die or no longer die from treatable diseases. Thank you.